Let us study how your customers will join a meeting. For that, you have to create your customers. You have to add them to a meeting room. You have to add them beforehand. And then we shall see how your customers are going to join the meeting. We'll give you a control panel like this. This is the address as of today. Maybe it is a testing address. So whatever it is, when you will get a login ID and password, the very first time you will be taken to a page like this. This page is mostly empty, but consisting of a few text boxes and maybe some arrangement. Basically, this is a bigger project. We are going to use a small subset of this. So every feature will not be of interest to us. We will take only the relevant part that is relevant for our Zoom meetings. Let us see. We'll explain the concept of a package first. A package is a course. A course consists of students or users. Packages have to be defined first. So for that we will add new package. A package will have an identifier package ID. This package ID is of 5 characters. We can choose any 5 characters. Package ID, a readable name of the package. This is not relevant to our meeting. We will ignore them. Keep the defaults. Once we define the packages, then we will add users to that. And then we will select the users for our meeting. These are the steps that we are going to follow. Let me explain each step in detail. So first of all, we are going to define a package. Type in a 5 character identifier. We have selected P0001. The readable name of the course, Molecular Biology, we have written. Ignore this. Click on Submit. When you submit, a package will be created. This is a row that appears here. The name of the package we picked, not relevant to our current Zoom application. This we will use for our Zoom application. And this is going to be used for adding users to this package. These we'll ignore for our present project. This is one package that has been configured. Let me configure one more. We have entered M0002. This is the friendly name of the package. And likewise, we will add it. And when you add, you get one row for the second one, one row for the first one. Likewise, you can configure other packages also. Now, it's time to add users to a package. Click on this one. We will be adding users to this course, M0002. We will add users to this course. User can be added one at a time, or maybe multiple users can be created with a single command, bulk. I will show how to do both of them. Let us add a single one user first. When you click on Add User, you will be shown Add User for package this one, the package to which we are adding users. Here we are to type a login ID for the user. Login ID can be any technically it can be anything, but I suggest to keep it numeric. Numeric is easier to type, easier to remember, and the least problematic. So you can either pick a receipt number or maybe the last 5 digits of a phone number or maybe the phone number completely. Type a user login ID for your customer. Your customer will be entering this login ID into the software that will be used by them to join a Zoom meeting. This will be used by your customers. At my own institute, I use phone numbers because our students can easily be told that you have to enter your phone number. But you can keep it anything. You can keep it any name like Lex, John, whatever. There is no restriction. But keep it continuous. Don't make it Lex Brown. This will cause problems. Keep it continuous. So even if you make some mistake, this software, this interface will tell you that you have made a mistake, correct it, or maybe it will make a correction on its own also. Replace this space by something, or maybe contract the space, but keeping simpler, smaller names is recommended. So type in the user login ID. Ignore this one, not relevant. Ignore this one, not relevant. The customer has an expiry date. His account has an expiry date. Click this one to add a date automatically 30 days ahead of today, 60 days, 90 days, whatever. Or you can use this drop down to configure a custom date. Type a rememberable friendly name for the user. This login ID was Lex. You could now type Bear for his name here. This name will appear. This will help you recall the person, especially if these are numeric, then this can be a good aid to remember the customer. So we have added a phone number. We have added a display name and we have picked some date for this customer. This date is not directly relevant, but if your customers have paid for a certain subscription, then this will help you determine. Somewhere in red it will show that the customer date has expired, so you can take a relevant action on that. So once you add the user, you will be shown a message, one user created, zero failed. So this is the user. His package is this one. Messages are not relevant to the current software. So this is what is the present state. Let us now add customers in bulk. Again, go to packages to add more users because the packages page was our starting point, and do all that process and come back to this page. Now I am showing how to add 3 customers together. You can add a maximum of 10 in bulk, 10 once, 10 next time, 10 next time. So you can add as many, there are no limits. But in one lot, in one go, you can create up to 10 customers. We do not impose any limits. The limits are on this box, 10 at a time. But you can otherwise create maybe thousands of them. There is no problem. Of course, pricing slabs may apply. Pricing slabs may apply. Do check with the pricing. Here, this first customer ID is 9988000001. The next one is written after a semicolon. So this you see is the second user. Then again a semicolon and 123459 whatever. That is the third user that we are creating. Nothing here, nothing here. And display name can't be same for everybody. So keep it blank. We can edit it later on. And click save. So the moment you click save, three users created, failed zero. This fail can occur if you are trying to add a user who is already there. So this is a notification. This is added, this is added, this is added. This is the friendly name of the first user. No friendly name, no friendly name, no friendly name. You can add it later on. Not relevant. This is the package to which these customers are applying now. Come back to the packages box again. We were doing this. We added this. Now is the time to add customers to this meeting. The customers have been added to the course, but now let us bring those customers to a meeting. So once you go to the meeting room, you will be shown all the customers of this package. You can make a selection, add or leave some of them, and click on add to meeting. So here you can click here. You will be taken to the meeting room. So, or you can view the meeting room if you want by clicking here also. So we'll click here and go to the meeting room. This is the meeting room. The meeting ID that you set up in the first step, in the first video, previous video. Meeting password we added there. You can change it here. Click here and you will be able to change them if you need it. These are the same as you have done on the zoom.us website. These are the same ones that we added in the previous video. This is how your customers join. The previous video was how you start the meeting. So there we made this configuration. Your Zoom account with Hovan has a validity. So this is the date that is shown to you. You will be able to conduct meetings till this date. And that is the pricing part. You can discuss later. This is the ticket. A ticket is an internal digit which is used by the software. You are not directly going to deal with it, but we suggest that you keep recycling them after a few days. There is nothing to worry about it. It is used internally, but you can recycle the tickets, or you should recycle the tickets after a few days. So if you added some user by mistake, you can remove the user right now. Click here. You will remove this person. Click here like that. So your job is now complete. You have added the users. Now let us see how your customer will join the meeting. As we told you, we will be giving an installation to your customer. Your customer will install it on the phone, Android phone, or on the Windows computer. I am showing it for the Windows computer. Interface for phone is exactly the same. So this is what your student will see on a Windows computer. On an Android phone, these two boxes will be shown to him and a click link will be there exactly in the same way. This is join meeting. Server will tell you what your server is. Your students will enter that here. Login ID. This is the login ID of the student that we just now created. This student will be told that you enter your login ID, that you enter your server. Password is not required because this login ID, this Hoven, is ultimately going to be verified on the server itself. So we have made it easier for your students. And then click to join. Just this thing is required. The next time these will be automatically saved. Your student doesn't have to keep adding. These will be already present. Just this single thing student has to do and the meeting will start. Now remember that when this meeting starts, a black screen will be shown in a video capture software, which is the ultimate objective of this whole protection. You can check it for yourself that your students will not be able to capture this. So this is it. These are the simple steps. So we will close it right now. Thank you.